Hello, kids. I'm the Sun, the center of the solar system that includes Earth. I'm here to teach you some amazing facts about our solar system and each planet in it. We'll also talk about the galaxy that we call home, the Milky Way. Joining me today is Aldo. He'll provide any Earth-based knowledge we need.
Hi, kids! I'm excited to be with a real star today!
Are you ready to learn?
I am ready!
The solar system is a group of objects that orbit around me, the Sun. These objects include 8 planets, 9 dwarf planets, and hundreds of moons. The solar system also includes millions of asteroids, comets, and small pieces of rock and ice. The solar system is very big, and it would take you a long time to travel from one end to the other. It takes light about 8 minutes to reach Earth from me. My light takes more than 4 hours to reach the dwarf planet, Pluto, and light is the fastest thing in the universe.
I don't know about that. I'm pretty fast. So, what is an orbit?
An orbit is the path that an object in space takes around another object. Let's orbit back to our solar system. The inner solar system includes the planets Mercury, Venus, Earth, and Mars. These planets are closer to me, and they are made mostly of rock and metal. The outer solar system includes the planets Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. These planets are farther from me, and they are made mostly of gas and ice.
Nice!
The asteroid belt separates these two groups of planets. Let's take a closer look at each planet. Mercury is the smallest planet in our solar system, and the closest one to me. It has no moons and no atmosphere. It is very hot on the side facing me, and very cold on the other side. Mercury takes about 88 Earth days to orbit around me, and about 59 Earth days to spin on its axis. That means one day on Mercury is longer than one year on Mercury.
Wow! I thought yesterday was a long day, but it wasn't longer than a year.
Yeah, Earth days are a good length. Going forward, when I say how long an orbit takes, or how long it takes a planet to spin on its axis, I'll just mention days and years as you experience them on Earth.
That will make it easier to understand. But what is an axis?
An axis is the imaginary line that a planet, or other object, rotates around.
Oh! We spin around our axis once a day. So, tomorrow we'll have completed one spin around our axis.
Yes, that is correct, Aldo. Now let's venture back to Venus. Venus is the second planet from me, and the hottest one in our solar system. It has a thick atmosphere of carbon dioxide that traps heat like a blanket. It also has clouds of sulfuric acid that rain down on its surface. Venus has no moons, and it spins in the opposite direction of most other planets. It takes about 225 days to orbit around me, and about 243 days to spin on its axis. One day on Venus is also longer than a year on Venus. Venus is brighter than any other planet or star in the sky after me. Now let us talk about the planet that is most familiar to our viewers.
My parents sometimes say that I live in my own world.
I think they just mean that you were daydreaming or not paying attention. Earth to Aldo. Let us go back to Earth.
Aldo, phone home.
Earth is the third planet from me, and the only one that we know has life on it.
Yeah, like me and all the kids watching now.
That's right, Aldo. It has a thin atmosphere of nitrogen and oxygen that protects us from harmful rays and allows us to breathe. It also has water on its surface that covers about 71% of it. Earth has one moon that orbits around it and affects its tides and seasons. Earth takes about 365 days to orbit around me and about 24 hours to spin on its axis. That means one year on Earth is equal to 365 days, and one day on Earth is equal to 24 hours.
I'm starting to see a pattern here. One trip around the Sun, or you, is one year depending on the planet you're on, and a day is one spin.
Exactly. Another fun fact, I'm 109 times larger than Earth.
Wow, that makes me feel tinier.
And I'm considered a dwarf star. Now, let's march back to Mars. Mars is the fourth planet from me, and the second smallest one in our solar system. It has a thin atmosphere of carbon dioxide that makes it look red because of dust storms. It also has polar caps of ice that change with the seasons. Mars has two small moons named Phobos and Deimos that orbit around it very fast. Mars takes about 687 days to orbit around me and about 25 hours to spin on its axis. That means 1 year on Mars is almost twice as long as 1 year on Earth. 1 day on Mars is slightly longer than 1 day on Earth.
I think it would be cool to explore another planet. We have sent many probes and landers to Mars. Several countries are planning to send humans to Mars in the future. Maybe we can all go on a field trip.
I can't go to Mars with you, but I'm sure the trip would be a blast. Let's jump back to Jupiter. Jupiter is the fifth planet from me and the largest one in our solar system. It has a thick atmosphere of hydrogen and helium. This makes it look like a giant ball of gas with colorful bands and storms. It also has a powerful magnetic field that protects it from radiation. Jupiter has at least 79 moons that orbit around it. The four largest are Io, Europa, Ganymede, and Callisto. Jupiter also has a ring system made of dust and debris. Jupiter takes about 12 years to orbit around me, and about 10 hours to spin on its axis. Scientists also believe that Jupiter is the oldest planet in our solar system.
Okay, Jupiter. Wow! 79 moons! Wolves would have a blast there! Maybe I should make a 79 moon and three wolves t-shirt!
Wolves probably wouldn't enjoy the atmosphere on Jupiter, but they'd sure love the moons. If you make a t-shirt in my size, I'll take one. But wait until you hear about Saturn. Saturn is the sixth planet from me and the second largest one in our solar system. It has a similar atmosphere to Jupiter, but with less storms and more winds. It also has a ring system made of ice and rock that stretches for thousands of kilometers around it. Saturn has at least 82 moons that orbit around it, including one large one named Titan. Titan has its own atmosphere and lakes of liquid methane.
Oh man, I was about to place the order for 79 moon and three wolves t-shirts. Should I change that to 82 moons now?
Aldo, you have a funny personality. If you can easily add three more moons to the shirt design, I'd say, go for 82. Saturn takes about 29 years to orbit around me, and about 11 hours to spin on its axis.
Saturn's name has a nice ring to it.
Pun intended?
Absolutely! Son, you've been around for a long time. I get confused sometimes about the difference between less and fewer. Do you know the difference?
I've been around for a while, but I'm still young at my core. But yes, I've studied languages for a long, long time. You should use less when you can't count things, and you should use fewer when you can count them. We haven't been able to count these events precisely, so less is the correct word in the previous example.
I've heard the planet names in other stories. Where do the names come from?
Humans named the planets, except Earth, after Greek and Roman gods and goddesses. The name Earth is from the Old English and Germanic words for ground or soil.
Humans are silly. Why did they choose a name that meant ground or soil when the Earth has more water?
Great question. I don't have the answer to that today. Let's circle back to the planets. Uranus is the seventh planet from me and the third largest one in our solar system. It has a thick atmosphere of hydrogen, helium, and methane that gives it a blue-green color. It also has a ring system made of dark particles that are hard to see. Uranus has at least 27 moons that orbit around it. The five largest are named Miranda, Ariel, Umbriel, Titania, and Oberon. Uranus is unique because it spins on its side. This means its poles are where most planets have their equators. Uranus takes about 84 years to orbit around me, and about 17 hours to spin on its axis.
Interesting. But what are poles?
Poles are where the axis meet the surface. You can imagine poles as the ends of a long pole, think flagpole, that the planets spin on. You can't see the pole, though. Here is an example of what the pole might look like for Earth. Do you see the pole?
Yes. I see the N for North Pole and the S for South Pole.
Great. Next up is Neptune. Neptune is the eighth and farthest planet from me and the fourth largest one in our solar system. It has a similar atmosphere to Uranus, but with more storms and winds. It also has a faint ring system made of dust and gas that is hard to see. Neptune has at least 14 moons that orbit around it. The largest moon, named Triton, has geysers of liquid nitrogen. Neptune takes about 165 years to orbit around me and about 16 hours to spin on its axis.
That would be a very long year. Imagine being born on Neptune right before the winter started. You'd probably really feel the phrase, winter is coming, eh?
I've personally never experienced a winter. Every time I get closer to planets during their winters, winter turns to spring.
I know a cool fact about Neptune. It was the only planet in our solar system that wasn't discovered by observation. It was discovered using math.
See, kids, study your math. Making our way back to the dwarf planets. The 9 dwarf planets in our solar system include Pluto, Ceres, Haumea, Makemake, and Eris. They are smaller than the 8 planets, and they have not cleared their orbits of other objects. They are located in 2 regions beyond Neptune, the Kuiper Belt and the Oort Cloud. The Kuiper Belt is a ring of icy bodies that includes Pluto, Haumea, Makemake, and many other objects. The Oort Cloud is a spherical shell of icy bodies that surrounds the whole solar system. These regions are very far from me, and very cold and dark.
Can you explain more about the difference between a planet and a dwarf planet, please?
I'd love to. Planets are the bosses of their orbit. They make sure other things get out their way. Dwarf planets have a bit of an issue clearing their orbits, so they don't have as much control.
Wow, cool! If I was a planet, I'd want to be a boss planet.
I'm sure you would be a boss planet, Aldo.
Do you mind if I ask you how old you are, son?
Sure. I don't mind. Scientists on Earth think I was formed 4.6 billion years ago. I was formed when part of a giant molecular cloud collapsed. Scientists think that the molecular cloud had a lot of hydrogen and helium. They also think that other stars could have been formed from the same cloud.
So, I know of Milky Way candy bars, but I've heard that our galaxy is also the Milky Way. What is a galaxy, and can you tell me more about the Milky Way?
The Milky Way is the galaxy that our solar system belongs to. A galaxy is a huge collection of stars, gas, dust, and dark matter that are held together by gravity. There are billions of galaxies in the universe, and they come in different shapes and sizes. The Milky Way is a barred spiral galaxy with a central bulge and 4 main arms that extend from it.
Only 4 arms? I have 8.
The spiderweb galaxy may have you beat. The Milky Way contains about 200 billion stars, including me, the Sun.
Wow! You have billions of brothers and sisters?
You could say that.
Well, you're the most special star to me and every other living thing on Earth.
Thanks, Aldo. I'm quite fond of Earth and its life. It makes the solar system more interesting. Although, those satellites you Earthlings have orbiting the Earth are obstructing my view.
I'll try to speak to someone about all those satellites.
Thank you, Aldo.
So, the Milky Way sounds really big. Where are we in the Milky Way?
We are about halfway between the center and the edge of the galaxy, in one of the minor arms called the Orion Spur. We are about 27,000 light years from the center of our galaxy. The Milky Way has a diameter of about 100,000 light years and a thickness of about 1,000 light years.
What is a light year? It sounds like time, but you said diameter, so now I'm confused. Diameter is like a distance, right?
It's okay, Aldo. It confuses a lot of people. A light year is the distance that light travels in an Earth year, or 365 days. This is about 9.5 trillion kilometers, or 5.9 trillion miles.
Wow. I thought the mile between my home and Sophia, the Adventurer Studios, was a long distance. Wait a minute! If we are so far from the center of the galaxy, is the light that we see from the center of the galaxy really, really old?
That's right, Aldo. When we look at the center of our galaxy, it is like we are looking into the past. We see it as it was 27,000 years ago.
So if the light we see is 27,000 years old, how old is the Milky Way galaxy?
Our galaxy is very old. It formed about 13.6 billion years ago from a huge cloud of gas and dust that collapsed and started to spin.
Wowza! You've given me a lot to think about. Thank you for all the information. I enjoyed spending time learning from such an old and wise star.
Thanks, Saldo. I enjoyed our time together, too. I'll be keeping an eye on you. I hope you enjoyed learning about our solar system and our galaxy with me. The Sun. There is so much more to discover in the vast universe that we live in. Thank you for watching Sophia the Adventurer. Have a sunny and bright day.
Please like and share this video if you liked it. And please consider subscribing to Sophia the Adventurer for more videos like this one.